Okay, does anyone have a good story? I'm getting bored.
I can tell you a story that Freddy told me about today. He told me that when he was passing an old mill near Bluebell Valley Station, he thought he heard a voice.
Hello? Anyone there?
Who is it? I think it was from that building over there.
Huh, that's kinda weird. I wouldn't expect to see a building that could speak.
Neither can I.
This is gonna make my story look like a masterpiece.
I wouldn't be too sure about that, Sir Handel. He did say it was real.
You're not scared, are you?
Don't be so daft! I'm not!
Scar Loki, would it be okay if I tell the next story?
Oh, I don't see. Why not?
Alright, who's next?
I do. It's called the Smokeboxless Engine.
Isn't that kinda like the Headless Horseman?
Once upon a time, there was a little railway, and on it were some little engines. One of them was a black well tank engine who had a similar shape to Duncan. He was a hard worker, and he did his work without hurry or haste. One day, one of the engines was supposed to be working at the quarry, but he had taken ill, and so he had to do it for him. The trucks, however, were being very troublesome that day.
What right is he to poke his funnel in here? Let's play a trick on him.
So when he tried to pull the trucks away, they he crashed into a cliff.
To fall onto him and crushed his smoke box.
They didn't have enough money to repair him, and so he was taken away to be scrapped. But however, They say that his ghost still haunts the railway to this day, looking for his lost smoke box. Some say he might be looking for yours.
Okay, that was a bit scary.
What's the matter, Peter Sam? Scared that the ghost train might get you?
No, I'm not. Just then, the thing controller arrived. Peter Sam, Duncan and Ivo Hugh, I have an important job for you. You are to collect some slate from the Blue Mountain Quarry that is needed to repair the Sodor River Bridge. Yes, sir. Peter Sam was nervous that he would bump into the Smokeboxless Engine along the way. On the way to the Blue Mountain Quarry, Duncan could see that he was scared, and so he teased him even more.
Be careful, the Smokeboxless Engine might find you.
There's no such thing as one. On the way, Peter Sam and Ivo Hugh passed an old mill which had not been used for a long time.
Who was there?
What was that?
I'm not sure.
I really hope it's not a ghost.
It must be that mill that Freddy told me about.
Hello, guys. I take it you're helping me in with this job, right?
We are, Smudger.
Why do you look so startled, Peter Sam? You look like you've witnessed something.
It was because I heard the voice on the way here.
Maybe it could have been the Smokeboxless Engine.
Duncan, will you cut that out? There's no such thing as a Smokeboxless Engine.
The Smokeboxless Engine? What's that?
It was a story that Bertram told us about, and he's been teasing Peter Sam about it along the way.
Oh, I see. Kind of like a train version of the Headless Horseman bit.
I thought you and Duncan's truck's ready for you, Smudger.
Thanks, Luke.
So Smudger coupled up to his trucks, and he and Duncan puffed away. While Peter Sam and Ivo Hugh went to collect their own slate for Paxton to collect as well as their own. Along the way, Smudger and Duncan heard the same voice again.
Hello? Anyone there? Hello? Anyone there?
What was that?
I have no idea. Hang on! No! It can't be!
Anyone there?
It's the Smokeboxless Engine! He's after us!
Are you sure about that?
It's true! He's real! He knows where we are!
and Duncan shot backwards as fast as he could.
Duncan, slow down!
But Duncan was so scared that he didn't listen to Smudger. Then his truck derailed and crashed into the mill!
I'm trying to warn you. You go get the train while I go back and tell the others about the accident.
Paxton and Ivo Hugh were getting ready to take the sleigh away. Paxton was to take it to the bridge, while Ivo Hugh was to take his train to the transfer yard so that it could be loaded into Stanley's trucks, so that he can also take them to the bridge when Smudger came puffing in. What's up, Smudger?
You can't leave with your trucks just yet, Ivo Hugh. Duncan has had an accident. He was going way too fast backwards because he heard about the whole Smokeboxless Engine thing that Bertram told you. And then his trucks crashed into an old mill nearby, and now your line is blocked.
Well, that serves him right after all his teasing. Anyways, I'll go and investigate where the voice came from. Ivo Hugh soon arrived at the scene of the accident. As the mess was cleaned up, he saw something. Well, bust my buffers! Who is that? There, in the remains of the mill, was an 06 OST. He looked very old and worn out.
Hello. I haven't seen another engine in a long time.
Who are you?
My name is Pioneer. I was the number 4 of the Wellsworth and Sudbury Railway.
What was it like back in those days?
Back in those days, I was a mixed traffic engine and I mostly pulled trucks and coaches. But I mostly preferred coaches since I never liked trucks.
One day in 1915, I was told to take a train of building supplies for the new viaduct between Marin and Kronk, but however, three engines from another railway were making fun of me and saying that I wasn't strong enough to pull them, and so they challenged me to add a lot more trucks to the train, and I did just that in order to prove them wrong.
But on the way, the trucks were up to no good again. But when I got to a hill, it got way, way worse. They bumped into me and knocked my driver and fire off the front plate. I couldn't stop. On, faster.
Help, I can't stop.
But then, I got switched onto another line, and I went tumbling down the hill and crashed.
When the mess was cleaned up, the fat director came to see me.
It wasn't my fault, sir. It was those trucks. They knocked my crew out of my cab, which caused all this to happen. And I also did that because it was in a bet with three other engines.
I know that it wasn't your fault, but your wheels have been badly damaged because of the tumble. And we can't afford the repairs at the moment, so you'll be placed into the siding for the time being.
Yes, sir.
I have a feeling that Izzy Hugh in trouble would be laughing at my misfortune. After I was rescued, I was put onto a flatbed and was left in the yards. The other engines would often keep me company. However, around 1956, I was later sent to the Great Waterton branch line 1 year after it reopened to replace an old boiler in the mill, but it was later closed in 1967 and I was left there ever since. By now, I think everyone else has pretty much forgotten about me.
I can relate to that. The only difference is that I was turned into a generator because of my carelessness on the Mid-Soar Railway. They bought a new engine called Stanley from America as replacement number 2. Then, in 1928, I was bought by a railway in Wales where they were able to fix my wheel alignment, but they later donated me to the Scarloy Railway.
I see. I've spent most of my time stuck in one place.
So it wasn't the Smokeboxless Engine after all. Is that what you're telling me?
No, I don't know what that is. It was a story that Bertram told me and Peter Sam about, and Duncan wouldn't stop teasing him about it. I see.
Maybe we can get Mr. Percival to ask Sir Tom Hatt if he can give you new wheels, and then you can work on the old stick castle line on the estate railway.
That's a great idea. The next morning, the two engines told the Fink controller, and he agreed.
You must be Pioneer. How did you know that?
Ivo Hugh and Smudger told me about you last night.
He also told me that you gave Duncan a good scare too.
I didn't even believe it at the first place.
Soon, Pioneer was taken to Crovan's Gate by a match where he was given his new wheels.
Thank you, Victor. I can't wait to be a working engine again.
You're welcome, my friend.
Once Pioneer got his new wheels fitted, he was sent to work at the estate railway with Stephen, Neil, Lady Cecil and Glynn. And from that day onwards, there was no more talk about the Smokeboxless Engine. Well, at least for a few weeks.